So second, welcome to you. I thought I also take the opportunity to give you a brief perspective of what we're expecting from you. Okay? So all of you know the local government has been passed for 25 years already, right? And one of the things that we like to acknowledge when local government codes it increased autonomy among local government units. So 25 years ago, the local government code was passed and it ushered in an age of relative autonomy among LGUs. It was uncharted territory there, but there are two things that we might want to think with regard to what it has brought. One is di natin maikakaila that it aided or led to new leadership. Okay, we have a lot of young mayors and entrepreneurs who came out of the government code, and that's something that we have to investigate. Okay, one is leadership, and another is the development of individual. And the number of the code, I feel, is we'd like to encourage local communities to take charge of their community. Okay. So there are two things, leadership and innovation. I think those are two things that we'd like to strive for in this school of our leadership. The innovations that Nagasaki, Marikina, and other LGUs did as a result of the local government code. According to Mayor Romero, hindi sapat na tayo ay matino lamang, hindi sapat na tayo ay mahusay lamang. Hindi lahat ay matino, at ng matino ay mahusay, lalo naman hindi lahat ay mahusay ay matino, ang dapat ay matino at mahusay. And this voluntarist statement, okay? And in that respect, what we want to encourage or develop, hopefully from you, is that some of you will become, ayun na, matino, mahusay, matino, mahusay. Okay? So hence, I highlighted three things in our time of school, of leadership, and governance. Okay? So the first point I wanted to talk about is school. Okay? So, ang tanong ko sa inyo, kailangan mo maging intelligent to be a leader. What do you think? What? Not necessarily, what?
For me, certainly, a public servant, you don't need the intelligent to help one another.
Okay, hindi kailangan mo maging intelligent. It's true. Ang matter, pero kailangan?
May kailangan.
Kailangan may kailangan. Okay?
Multiple
intelligences. Okay? So then, what are you doing? Are you smart? Interpersonally? Emotionally? Emotionally? Are you smart?
Dr. Einstein, you should have been doing it. Balance.
It's not so much smart to get it. Okay? I think one of the first important things that I expect from you is that you are inquisitive. Okay? Because I think that's one of the premises here, that in our society, a lot of things change, a lot of assumptions change. Okay? Sabi ni Freeman Rabowski, smart simply means you're ready to learn. And nobody has a monopoly of all the knowledge. And so in that, I believe you are smart because you are here, expecting to learn something. Okay? So in that regard, if I ask, are you smart? I would like to believe you are smart for recognizing that there is always something you can learn. Okay? Added to that, sabi natin, kailangan mahusay, I'd like to challenge you to be original, to innovate, at mahuna. Okay?
Okay, I think part of leadership is pag-muna, okay, being a leader, okay, being a leader, you don't necessarily have a global knowledge. Okay, so the next point is full of leadership. So the leadership, okay, kaya ang sabi ng Jesse Rebel, ba't kailangan mag-usay at video. And in this program, we'll have a leadership program now around 8 to 10 former members. And I think part of the idea there is that leadership is also very difficult to teach. Okay? Part of it is developed over life. It is through experience. So the idea is we have experience people who are going through what you want to or what you are going to. Some of them, of course, most of them are neighbors. But most of them, some of them also have went through the process of being a counselor, being a vice mayor, before becoming a neighbor. Okay? So the idea here is you would like to actually try to pick their ways. The idea here is also to pick each other's ways, to learn from each other. So again, a challenge to be an original, to innovate Mamuna. Okay? What does it mean to be original? Okay? Original means it's the origin of something from which something springs. Okay? When we apply to you, one of the things we ask of you is simply interest you. Okay? And a lot of the things, a lot of the ideas, a lot of the challenges of change for our projects come from your interest. Okay? So marami sa inyo nag-fit ng idea or project. Okay? I'm sure na tumabo kayo. Mayroon na kayo yung idea. Okay? So let's start from that. Okay? That's the origin. Okay? That something will bring and hopefully from it bring something bigger. Original means a thing of singular or unique character, a person who is different from other people in appealing and interesting way, a person of fresh initiative or inventive capacity. So we'd like to believe you are that person. Okay? You can be original. Okay? That's it. We also like to think of innovation. Innovation is built on creative ideas as basic elements. It's built on ideas. Okay? Again, original is also emanates from something, from an idea. Okay? So, again, it's an output that we'd like to come out of this project. Is that at the end of the coming months, you have an idea, a project, a policy, an initiative that you want to develop, and hopefully as you think the brains of each other, exchange ideas, something comes out of it. Okay? Hopefully whether it's a project, whether it's something that you sell to a funding agency, or something that you can sell to your neighbor or your counselor or your other people in your community, so much the better. Okay? So the point here is, again, from your ideas, we'd like to have innovation. The other thing we'd like to talk about is organizational innovation. You cannot innovate by yourself. You have an idea, you have to be able to execute it. To execute it, you require an organization. The organization is your local government unit. But in governance, it's not just a local government unit that works. Okay? So to be successfully implemented, what does it require? Okay? It requires the participation of so many entities, so many organizations, so many groups. Okay, so hopefully, from the experience that the speakers will give you, okay, hopefully we'll be able to tell you how what made them successful in implementing the various topics, fields that they will be talking about. Some of them will be talking about entrepreneurship, some of them will be talking about education, health, and youth development. Maybe those are the things that you are, or at least most of some of you are interested in. So we'll try to match you with people who have experience in implementing such kinds of programs. Okay. I started off with the local government tool, but we said part of the success of the local government tool was creating innovation. Okay, we try to replicate or try to celebrate that with the Very Poor Awards. The Very Poor Awards says innovate, solve problems, make a difference. Okay? And one of our colleagues in the college,
or we're being Dr. Alex Villar, also former director of the CLRG, actually studying after 10 years of doing POC programs, what are the different aspects or factors in the successful doing POC program? And I think you could, you as officials in the Marriage Group of the Unit, might be able to recognize some of these factors. Okay? So, standards for innovation at the local level. So, we have to know it's a profitable policy environment. Okay? So, that means that you have to make context to not everything is new. I'm pretty sure you would value that according to value, the policy environment to value. Okay? It's ideal that there's a profitable policy environment. Some of you might be opposition, some of you might be the Ariana mayor. It's actually that ideally you could be able to work within that policy environment in order to sell the kind of programs you want to develop. Secondly, during crisis, and for this time, the reason you are running, the reason you are proposing something is because of recognizing a problem. It could be a problem sa basura, it could be a problem about maternal health. It could be a problem about trust. It could be the fact of triggering crisis. Usually, the triggering crisis allows for the policy environment to mature and to enact, to make people work together. Second is an aggressive LGU and an aggressive civil society organization. I love them together. Dr. Durant had it with a separate item. But I thought this was my last idea of governance. Okay? So it's not just the LGU that works, okay? It works with other entities. Okay? So again, recognizing the focus of our LGU, recognizing the other support that you can get, how to make them work for you. Fourth is the adequate financial resources. Okay? You need to be getting a lot of money. Okay? So besides that, usually, inadequate financial resources spurs innovation. Okay? So some people see it as a problem, other people see it as an opportunity. Okay? So that is for that limited resources, which I believe maybe as you have limited resources. Then you have to create it. You have to create it to generate resources, find partners, find alternatives to make it affordable and then make it sustainable. Okay? I remember the other backing the Lipo Award. They built a cemetery. In the cemetery, they were waiting for the government of the cemetery. And they were able to find the cemetery. So it was a combination of solving the problem of cemetery and making the things beautiful and also sustainable. Okay? Next is demand for a specific breakthrough. A lot of you might be thinking about services, maybe services like health, teaching, education, social services, social work, social welfare, maybe fire brigade, okay? But what is the demand comes from your consumer? Okay? So you also have to recognize the differences in the needs of your LGU. The other is local training, capacity building. This is one example. Because the training will be from the location, it will be from the community, it will be about disaster risk reduction. Okay? And sometimes from the training, you pick up new ideas. Okay? But the idea is, even with national programs, international programs, there's always a need to localize it. They need to open it, just about that. So the same thing with innovation, innovation need not be original. Okay, sabi ka nila, yung nakukuna ka, most likely nakukuna na yung cabinet. So, example would be, Yahoo was first before Google, but Google did the idea better. Okay, you don't necessarily have to have a very original idea. You could always improve on the idea or the project to make it fit your context. Do you have any questions so far? Hello? Okay. The other idea. Okay? Recognizing original ideas. Siguro, one of the things I want to always think about as counselors or as a vice mayor is to question the report. Okay? You see, yun, pero may mas nasabi natin, ang tradisyon na yan, kinagawihan na natin yan. Okay? But remember, times change. Okay? Kahit man, I mean, hindi mo pwede sabihin na hindi mo ginagawa ng dati. Okay? Kaya yun yung batas. But sa tonal section, this is because they may kinabukal ko. The only way to ask people is to always ask, bakit nga ba natin ginagawa na? Pwede ba natin mo in a different manner? Second is to triple the ideas you generate. Okay? The best way to have good ideas or to have groundbreaking ideas is to actually have as much ideas as you can. So, in your ideas, before they might be known for 10 compositions, but we actually compose over 300. Okay? Or Edison might have been known for the laptop. We actually patented over thousands of ideas. Okay? So it's the thing is you have to encourage developing ideas. Don't be enamored with that one idea na kailangan bumabenta. Okay? Sometimes, akala ko yung bumabenta and there's a simpler one and that's what works. Third, I think this is something a lot of my staff and myself like. It's actually to procrastinate strategically. I don't say to procrastinate. You are still procrastinating. That's why.
Take your time.
Take your time. Hindi ka magbadali. Okay? Pero kung saan, hindi nyo dapat magpapag. Okay? So, kanyang, ginagawa ko yung slide yung ito. Actually, nasa atas ang ito ko na yung outline. But I was still working on it a few weeks ago. Okay? But the idea is, hindi ka magbadali. Okay? Let the idea journey. Okay? But carrying around, throwing around, until eventually it develops into something that is already better. Okay? Hindi pinagdali. Okay? And then, fourth, you have to seek more feedback from peers. So, your peers is mga kasama mo, pero hindi sinay, kasi kailangan mo. Okay? Sometimes you can throw ideas to your friends, all they say is, oh, maganda yan. Okay yan. But if they say it's okay, then you're actually not improving on your idea. The best thing to develop your idea is actually get critique and feedback. Okay? So again, the one is, question number one, triple the idea, brainstorm, generate more ideas, try to find time, okay, we can get out of the meeting. Try to find out what should we need. Okay? And then try to be more vocal to your peers and make you do that. Okay? Next point is how you can champion the original idea. The idea did not be from you. Okay? It could be from your constituent. Okay? If many of you have a generic idea, it's also important for you to recognize what a good idea is. Okay? Sometimes you have to be a little negative. Bakit mo ako yung mga work to take me ako? Okay? You know why? Because it works to be negative. Kasi if you're too positive about the idea, inibenta mo, people will start criticizing na how it is in class. But as you can see, parang hindi mo to work, then people are forced to think of hindi, kaya natin mas lower class. So people start thinking of ways of advancing communication is very important. So you're able to generate other solutions and make your idea better. Second is make your ideas familiar. You see, hindi kailangan successful to yung proposing an idea the first time. Okay? But the more times you need to make it, okay, the more times you talk to people about it, the more accepted it becomes. It becomes the norm. Okay? I'll give you an idea, then again, you don't necessarily have to agree with it. Okay? But I don't necessarily agree with it. Do you remember the last election? Our President Duterte was the only one who actually said drugs is a problem. Okay? I don't think anybody thought that was a problem. But he keeps reiterating and reiterating it in every message that he says. And we don't know everybody's talking about drugs as a problem. Okay? You need to ask that every day. The point is, okay? If you keep reiterating your idea, then people might start disagreeing about it. It's part of resistance, it's partly also kind of part of convincing people about a problem. Services speak to different audiences. Your idea, don't just talk to the same people. Don't just talk to your party mates. Try to find people in the same group, not necessarily the same problem, but perhaps with the same strategy. And you could write a note. Only attend your value up. Okay? Instead of changing people's mind, you could appeal to value. Okay? Talk to values or beliefs they already hold. Okay? So we don't talk about it's a bit about the drug problem. I think everybody can agree that children are important, that family is important, okay? That education is important. Okay? Try to find the values where you share with other people. You remember, hindi tayo pala pareho ng pala. Okay? Pero tinahapan natin na paraan para hanapin kung saan tayo maasin. In closing, I think the objective here in this program is what to develop your ideas. Okay? And I think that's one of the more important things that we want to do. Graduate from. You have ideas, you are counselors, you have programs that you want to push for. Okay? I know not satisfying the job of a counselor. Okay? But that said, your ideas matter and your ideas can shape your lower government. So one of the things I'd like to think about is ano ba yung mahalaga sa akin as we move to the project and we move to the area that I want to develop. And then hopefully from this 6 sessions or 7 sessions, you'll be able to come out of here with a better idea. I'd like to pick up or learn more speakers. You might have different experience yet. Okay, learn from how they manage political process, how they manage to work with the Diliman, and how they manage opposition, their ideas. Okay, you might have different context and try to pick out how that applies to you. Third, make your future sound work. Like I said, you can only learn from us, but we also have some limited experience. I was never a counselor. Okay? I'm speaking here as an academic. You might know it better than me. They might know it better than me. So this is always a community of practice. So that it is learn from each other. And the fourth is watch out for opportunities. At the end of the SLG, we'll try to invite, we'll have a marketplace and we'll try to invite some funding agencies. You might have ideas that we like. But some of the opportunities to all come from each other. Like I said, maybe the resources need to create into the windfall. Maybe the resources need not be funded by actual funds. But there's sometimes the people. Okay? So there are volunteer capital, volunteer social capital, which is human capital aside from financial capital. So watch out for opportunities. Okay? So that's it, good luck, and then the rest of the day is filled with inspiration and wonder.